FR Media presents the NJCAA Region 21 Men's Championship Game between the Bunker Hill Community College Bulldogs of Boston and the Bristol Community College Bayhawks of good old Fall River. We're here at Springfield Technical Community College in Springfield, Massachusetts for today's contest. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm David Cardoza. Alongside me is the infamous Double A, Mr. Andrew Augustus. Andrew, we got the rematch that we've been wanting, buddy. So we got the rematch of last Sunday's MCCAC Championship game in which Bunker Hill came out the victors. Today, Bristol Community College looking for sweet, sweet revenge, baby. Looking for sweet revenge. It looks to be a thrilling contest. This is something that has eluded Bristol Community College. This is something that has eluded them in their 8-year history. They never been to the national tournament. If they win today, they get to the national tournament. And I just want to ask you this one question. Can they do it?
They can do it. I mean, it all depends on which team we want to show up here. Are we going to see the team that went down that 11-game win streak, really dominating their opponents, beating this Bunker Hill team on the road in February to earn that spot? Or are we going to see the team that we kind of saw yesterday in the championship game last week, a little sluggish start, a little undisciplined getting into trouble? This is a tale of two teams, a little Jekyll and Hyde, if you will, for the Bayhawks. And if the Bayhawks really today need Mr. Hyde, they don't need Dr. Jekyll.
Well, Bristol Community College has been on a roll. They lost last Sunday against this Bunker Hill team, and they were on an 11-game win streak, but they won again yesterday. Basically, they've only lost once in the last 2 months.
They have. It's 2016 has only brought them one loss. And it's a tough loss against a very talented, athletic, big team in Bunker Hill. Now, the big issue we saw last week that they need to fix is discipline. I talked about it going into the pregame last time. Bunker Hill's an undisciplined team. We saw them in foul trouble again yesterday, playing Mass Bay again. Now, this week, if you are the Bayhawks, you need to make sure that you get Bunker Hill in foul trouble and not the other way around.
What did you see last week in the championship game last week? What did you see in a Bristol Community College team, a team that had been on a roll, that had been riding high? What changed for them? What happened in that game down the stretch?
It looked like it was just the moment got too big at times. A lot of unforced errors, making unwise passes, if you will, and just really trying to rush it rather than doing what they do best, let the game come to them. Now, like you said, they are a better team when they're running the break and they're running a full court press and kind of keeping the other team off balance. But the only way you can do that effectively is if you are on the end being able to compete with that. Now, this is a deeper team, bigger team, stronger team. The one thing we want to look out for is Tron Griffith. Last week, going out with a shoulder injury, looks like he is back and he is starting. It was his right shoulder last time, so it'll be interesting to see before. And, of course, Elijah Rogers, who looked like he was in a serious injury and then comes back and just puts the door away. So it's going to be interesting to see how these two teams come out today. But I can tell you one thing. If the Bayhawks want to win and want to be the NJCAA Region 21 champions, they need to have their best game of the year.
And we talked about the energy, something that they really lacked yesterday. But they basically really toyed with Northern Essex last night, because they didn't go into their press. They didn't go into any of their half-court trap. They didn't really have a pressure defense. But then again, they didn't really have to, did they?
They did not have to. They controlled the game from the beginning, and the big difference between those two, that rematch of yesterday, was that they at least controlled it from the beginning, and they had the lead at half and were able to extend it. So right now, if you are the Bayhawks, you were up 3 at halftime last week. You need to do whatever you did in that first half. Do that for a whole 40 minutes, and you'll win the game.
Well, the Bayhawks are getting set for today's Region 21 final. They win today. They're going to the Big Apple in New York. We're going to send it down to courtside as the player introductions are about to take place here at Springfield Technical Community College.
Number 14, Jeremiah Lockdown. Rounding out the starting five, Bill Christopher Hawks. Number 14, he is a freshman five forward, Ryan Baker.
Okay, so the stars to look out for Bristol Community College, Mr. Jarrell Gomes, a top 10 scorer in the country, number one right there. As Bristol Community College comes on the court in their dark green jerseys with the white trim on the side. A rematch of last week's MCCAC championship game in which Bunker Hill came out on top on their own home court in Boston at Bunker Hill Community College, a tournament that they hosted. It was on their floor. Today, they're a little bit far away from home, aren't they? They're not in Kansas anymore. They're not in Beantown anymore.
Boston is a long way from Springfield, especially for us New Englanders. We think a 30-minute car drives a road trip. So this is a hike, to say the least.
I don't think of Springfield as Massachusetts.
I still do. Worst case, after the game, I can go ride some rides. It's perfect.
Basketball Hall of Fame right down the road, home of the Basketball Hall of Fame, Armani Baker. Tipping off for the Bristol Community College Bayhawks, and the chip is going to be in Bunker Hill's favor. Here's number one, Elijah Rogers. He's the floor general. He's one of the guys you got to look out for on this Bunker Hill team. He's the leader. He's the guy. He's the engine that makes the ship run, that's for sure. Three-point shot. Good. Good by number 14, Evan Bean, the freshman, getting the start today. 6'5" forward from North Quincy High School. Down the other end, turnover by the Bayhawks. And here comes new Tron Griffith. We spoke about Tron Griffith and his injury and what that meant to Bunker Hill last week. They still got the victory, and he's back in the lineup. So they got their number one and two backcourt, literally.
He is favoring that left hand, though, the whole time. He won't even catch the ball with two hands.
BCC coming out in zone. They lob it in. This is something they did last week all day long. And number 12, David Stewart, going back to the line. And here we go again. Here we go again, Andrew.
They're going to say that foul is going to be charged, I believe, to Jarrell Gomes.
Not the way you want to start, especially if you're Jarrell Gomes. You don't want to start getting into foul trouble now. He was in foul trouble last week. I believe he ended a foul out of the game, as did several other Bayhawks last week.
I believe it was four foul outs, and this is the guy you don't want to send to the line. He had over 20 free throws yesterday and hit 17 of them last week.
And he's starting right again where he left off. Two free throws sunk, and it's all just like that. It's 5-0, less than a minute to, not even a minute in. Bunker Hill bringing pressure now. Nice strong take there by Armani Baker. Loves driving.
That's what you got to do.
Loves driving
against
baseline.
This team will get into foul trouble. You got to drive the lane, make the big man's get into the foul trouble, and then that'll open up your perimeter for your shooters like Ephraim, like Gomes, and like Nelson.
And if you're the Bayhawks, you got to be, I mean, you got to be able to stop the Bunker Hill offense. I mean, their offense isn't that mysterious. I mean, a lot of times they just like to dump it into their big guys. They'll literally try to lob it into guys like Stewart and Freedom's Denius, who's 6'8". David Stewart is 6'4". They have a big front court. They like to just lob it into those guys. Get a deny on the basketball. One free throw made there by Armani Baker.
You got to hit.
Here comes that trap. Bean. Here's a 6'8" Denias, kicks it back out to Bean. Almost knocked away by Nelson. Tron Smith driving to his left, puts it up, and good. Floats it in and good.
Still only using that left hand.
Long pass to Nelson. Gets it blocked. What a block by Denias. By David Stewart. What a block. He came out of nowhere. Got his team pumped up.
Nelson, about 5'10". Stewart, 6'4". You're not going to win that one.
Gomes picks up his dribble. Has Armani Baker inside. Flips it up, but he can't get it to go. Rebound was by Denias.
Can't start forcing it.
In the corner, Bean gets Gomes to leap. The jumper missed by Bean. Now pushed up by Ephraim. Ephraim, nice move. Drives to his left. Another block. This time by Denias. Going the other way. Rogers has Nelson. Oh, underneath. Nice pass underneath to Stewart.
Ephraim got caught looking for the foul call. Can't do that. You're just going to get back after a block.
Gomes from the wing, from the side. Ooh, it rolls out. Elijah Rogers to push. Oh, nice pass. What a pass. Boy, that Rogers is special. And Rob Delalu will get a timeout. That their size, they have nothing to weapon that right now.
Two and a half minutes gone by. It's already a 10-point Bunker Hill lead. You've got to stop them. Yesterday, so many similarities to a week ago. Because like we were talking about in this championship game was in the semifinal game, you wanted to defend the perimeter. Now this game, you need to defend down low. They are not doing that right now. Bunker Hill's just having their way with the Bayhawks.
And the Bayhawks, this month, at the beginning of this month, they beat Bunker Hill at Bunker Hill by 20 points. So it's not like they can't beat this team. They've beaten this team before. They've beaten them this year. Now, Bunker Hill got the best of them early on in the season in November and last week in the championship game. So Bunker Hill has a 2-1 advantage in the season series. This is the fourth meeting between the two teams. So, but right now, as you said yesterday, if you're Bunker Hill Community College looking at Northern Essex Community College and Bristol Community College last night, you're not scared of either of those two teams, and it shows right now. They look like a much better team, the more well-oiled machine.
Right now it's just bigger, stronger, faster. I think that's the only way it can be described for the Bayhawks. And now they're going to come up with a lot of pressure up top.
Okay. Ephraim with Cotton. Bunker Hill's defense swarming. Armani Baker going baseline. Loves that move. I think Stewart got a piece of that. Oh, Griffith, nice pass to, just overthrew Bean. Had him underneath. Bunker Hill really looking to push the basketball. Once they get it, they're in transition. They're pushing the basketball up court. Griffith to Nelson. Nelson getting the lane. Oh, he can leap. Need more of that.
Nice job by Nelson there. Kind of an interesting defensive ideal brought on by Danius. Not really attacking it and letting it get the easy two. And nice turnover by the Bayhawks. I thought the ref was starting to call a foul, but we were seeing Bing come in for the Bayhawks. But that's a very good defensive possession there. Make Rogers dribble it off his own foot.
And as you spoke about Nelson's layup right there, and Danius not going after it, Nelson really got up, though.
He's got height.
Yeah, he got some
that's
height on
travel.
That. So, and Bing. Careless turnovers that you can't have.
You can't bunny hop it. I don't know what he was thinking on that one. I mean, just ball goes in, he catches it, and then takes a little hop. That's just a mental lapse there by Bing.
That's for sure. Bing definitely has the height to match up. Not sure about the athletic ability. Got the big body. Rogers getting in the lanes. Oh, nice move. Couldn't get it to go, though. Ephraim now looking to push. Looking to push towards the basket. Puts up the, oh, another block. My goodness. Another pluck by Stewart. Rogers going the other way. Flips it up over Nelson. Nelson came to block that one. Couldn't get it, though. Now BCC pushing it. Gomes with the reverse layup. Misses it.
You've got to put it up
Bing
smart.
Bing misses, and then it goes out of bounds.
You got to go up strong with that if you're Bing. Right now, the Bayhawks, 4 minutes have gone by, and the Bayhawks have 3 points. That's less than a point a minute.
And BCC looking flustered here in the early going. See a couple frustrated looks, Jarrell Gomes especially. He needs to be the man. They'll dump it in to the big man, Danius, being guarded by Bing.
Jump ball.
Going to be a jump ball, and it's going to go BCC way.
Smart play there by Gomes to get his hand in as he was going up. Jump ball, easy turnover.
Bunker Hill likes to run that little 2-1-2 offense with the big man coming up. Here's Bing. Bing loses his footing.
I got tripped. Danius kind of put two hands on him and put his foot out. But also it looked like Danius might have rolled his ankle on that one.
You could score on this Bunker Hill. You could score on this Bunker Hill defense.
You
could
score on the inside. It's not like a big mystery here. You just bring them in, and now you're going to keep getting these guys in the foul trouble by bringing it in, going up and strong. That's the one weakness of a team that has this kind of size. They are very athletic, and sometimes their athleticism can be an Achilles heel.
And Bing sinks the first one.
Because you see players like Stewart who love to block, make the nice fancy block shots, but if he mistimes that, that's a hard foul. That it could easily come into a flagrant.
Jason Bing His second attempt, nice rotation, tickles the twine. 13-5 in the early going. 15:40 left to play in this one, in the first half. Way long cross court pass to Stewart, and goes up over a leaping Baker and Bing. Scored for Mr. Stewart. 10-point lead for the Bulldogs.
Stewart picking up where he left off.
Ephraim kicks it over to Nelson. Nelson inside to Baker. That's his spot, going baseline. Loses the basketball. Nelson comes away with it. Now it's lost, picked up by Tron Griffith.
See, only using his left hand. If I'm defending him, I'm making him use that right hand. He doesn't want to catch it. He barely wants to move that thing. Make him use
Bean,
it right.
Bean in the corner,
nice
gets
block.
A block by Nelson. And they're going to say it's off Jarrell Gomes.
I thought Gomes did a great job staying out of that way. He threw it right off the foot, but I guess it must have hit him before it went out, before it hit the ground.
In for Bunker Hills, number 4, France Francois. Ooh, driving the lane. Loose control of it, Bean. And it's going to stay right here. They're going to say it's off Jason Bing, it looks like.
Bing getting his hand there, tipping away down low. Nelson's, you got to have the big man.
They'll dump it in. Does Stewart gets it knocked back. New shot clock.
All you've got to do is hit the rim. 10-point lead still for the Bulldogs.
Elijah Rogers. Stewart setting a pick up top. BCC in that 2-3 zone. Ephraim out to get Rogers.
Little over anxious there by Baker making that contact. At least it was on the floor.
And Bunker Hill will get a new shot clock. Josh Banks coming in.
And we got a timeout, Bunker Hill.
Okay, so early on, 15-5. I feel like even though it is 15-5, it could be a lot worse.
Yeah,
it could be a lot worse, right?
Bayhawks lucky to be down by 10 right now. They're just getting out-hustled, out everything in every aspect of this game. It's incredible to be only down 10.
Yeah, but talk about the tremendous length. Freedon's Denias, a sophomore forward, 6'8", went to Cambridge Bridge and Latin High School. I mean, that's a top high school there in Boston. That's a great basketball school right there. Davis Stewart, sophomore forward, who we've seen that's been dominating this contest on both ends, especially on the defensive end too, with a couple blocks there early on.
8 points, 2 blocks.
8 points, 2 blocks. He runs at 6'4", and he's a husky. He's a husky guy.
No, that's not husky. That is an athletic build right there. That's not husky.
No, I shouldn't say husky. Strong.
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 Let's
just say strong.
Nice.
Solid.
Nice
solid.
Job by Banks getting his arm in.
Francoy to inbound from the corner. Gets the basketball. Ooh, Bing went for the up fake. Francoy got him up in the air, and he drops it in the paint. 17-5. 14:20 to go in the first half.
Shots need to start falling if you're the Bayhawks.
Jarrell Gomes for three.
Can't force
needed
that.
Needed to get that one. Bing with the putback. Can't get it to go.
Looked like there was some contact down there. Refs are letting them play, which is a good sign.
Unlike last week when you had a million foul calls, well, that's what it felt like. Bunker Hill, they like to flip the ball around. They get it inside of Stewart. Lays it in off the glass.
10 points already.
Inbound pass deflected by Rogers. Nice heads-up play there. 19-5. BCC in danger of getting blown out of the gym here in Springfield. Crossover dribble from the top of the key. Ephraim is going to get fouled, and he'll step to the line. Number 13, Jeremiah Ephraim, he needs to get going. Yesterday, as we've seen, Andrew, when he gets going, when he starts going to the hole, he can make that pass. And he's such a great slasher. He finishes well at the rim, too.
Like the first. That was his problem last week, too, in the championship game. He just was missing free throws, and it's just a costly error.
I'd like to see BCC get more aggressive on the offensive end. They keep settling for these jumpers. They're getting intimidated by Stewart and Denias, those big guys. The second free throw missed by Ephraim.
Bing could have had that. Just wasn't prepared for it.
The back quarter, Rogers and Griffith is solid.
Every time Griffith gets the
ball.
They'll
dump it in. This is what they like to do. Inside and the foul. David Stewart. And Bunker Hill, they just play with such a swag. I mean, they're energetic. They are energy. They're in your face. and it's a 21 to 6 ball game. Davis Stewart steps to the line to try to complete the three-point play. 6'4" sophomore forward from Madison Park. Went to Madison Park, Volk Tech. He completes the triple play there. 22-6. Ephraim being guarded by Stewart, puts it up, and he'll go to the line. Jeremiah Ephraim, the only guy generating any kind of offense for Bristol.
The one thing about Stewart, too, is whenever he fouls a guy, because that was an obvious foul, kind of pushing his body into him, it always seems like he didn't do anything wrong. You did once in a while. It's a foul.
I think he just tries to will his way to do anything, and that's what makes some of the great players great. Can't say that he hasn't dominated so far in this game and last week.
Free throw struggles continue.
Got to make the free throws. Your points are being scarce as it is. You got to make your free throws when you get free throws. Here's Elijah Rogers. Crosses over. Gets it to the paint. Swoops it up with the left hand. God, he's so imaginative with the way he plays.
That could have been a foul on Stewart. Stewart a little push in the back to Bing.
Ooh, pulling it up aggressively.
Foul on the floor. Looks like that's going to be.
Jarrell Gomes having a laugh over there. Like, finally I get one.
Sean Miller with his first team fifth.
New shot clock for the Bayhawks. Kicking it way back out to Jeremiah Ephraim from Gomes. Gomes goes and gets it from the wing. God, he's had a bad shooting weekend so far. Misses that, but Nelson will come away with it. Get it into the big man. Gets it into Bing. Turns around.
That's
solid
a
contact, and he'll go to the line. Bing's getting a little chippy.
Stewart's running into Bing. And then the ref's talking to Bing.
He was straight up. He said he didn't put his hands on me, nothing.
So Bing will go to the line shooting too.
Things get a little chippy. That's what we like to see. 22-6. Like to see some kind of attitude, some kind of aggression from this Bayhawks team. Don't get punked. Don't get punked out there by this team from Boston. 22-7.
Banks and Ephraim taking a break. Perez and Baker in. And checking in for the Bulldogs is Rubunis Guerrier. Rubens.
22-7. A lot of time. A lot of time to go on this one.
Plenty of time. You're just going to start scoring. And you're going to stop
again,
missing free
another
throws.
Another missed free throw. Same story.
Rogers looks to be wincing.
Elijah Rogers, so responsible, so good with the basketball, though. That's who you want the ball in his hands. Flips it in. Now to Stewart.
Nice block there.
That was a nice entry pass by Elijah Rogers to get that one to France Francois, who then slipped it over to Stewart. Lost the ball out of bounds, but it's going to stay Bunker Hill basketball. They'll get it in to Stewart. Nice defense by Bing. He'll throw it off Bing. And Bing and Stewart, they're getting into a slant. They're getting into a nice little confrontation right now.
Well, the thing is, Bing's just standing there, and Stewart throws the elbow every time he walks by.
Driving to the hole. Tried to go over Bing, and he does. It drops in. Elijah Rogers.
And that is an off foul. Another careless foul. And here's the situation. If Miller gets in trouble, they're probably going to bring back in Griffith. Griffith can't use his right hand right now. So if I'm the Bayhawks and he gets the ball, all I'm doing is making sure he's going to his right. He can dribble with his left. He's talented with it. His right's bothering him. Make him use his right hand.
That's what you got to do. And right now, Andrew, talk about the foul discrepancy right now, because
last week it was reversed as last week. Last week the Bayhawks were in foul trouble, and Bunker Hill was playing a more disciplined game. Now this time it's the other way around, but the score is still heavily in Bunker Hill's favor.
And Perez makes both free throws. Talk about the importance of how many. I mean.
If you don't hit the free throws, you're going to lose this game. That's the only way you can claw your way back in. They have one field goal.
But they're in the bonus. They can slowly get back in this one. They can just take the ball to Bunker Hill. Rogers gets it to the lane. Nice pass to Stewart. Goes up over Baker. And Stewart will go to the line again.
Stewart's going to be careful slamming that ball down. We saw in the last game, in the women's game, someone got a technical for doing that. So, just saying, it's very possible. You want to hear this place erupt. Watch him. If he gets a technical for slamming the ball down, it'll be insane.
Oh, my goodness. And a missed free throw by Stewart.
Smart foul there by Baker, even though he's got two. But it was a smart foul because he at least saved at least 1 point.
And to me, Baker, even though he's not, doesn't have the height as a Jason Bing, to me, he's their best inside presence. Perez pushing it up, gets it to Welson on the wing. Nelson turns that ball over. Frank Coy, number four, going down court. Flips it back to Elijah Rogers, who will bring it back out. Again, the zone by the Bayhawks. That jumper.
Why? I don't get why Nelson decided to go for that. He was off balance. It was going to be a miss. But it kind of bailed him out there. So two shots for Sean Miller.
Sean Miller, we didn't see too much of him last week. The freshman guard, 5'8", from English High School. Makes the first free throw. Coming in is Kevin Desire and Jeremiah Ephraim. Coming in for Jason Bing and Josh Nelson, respectively. Miller's second free throw is good.
This Bunker Hill team, you can't put them at the line because they'll take advantage of it.
That's for sure. Here's Jarrell Gomes. Loses the basketball. Stewart comes up with it, up to Elijah Rogers. BCC in their 2-3 zone. Sean Miller, that's a deep three. Front rims it. Rebounded by Jeremiah Ephraim.
That could have been a foul.
Yeah, Elijah Rogers was all over his back there. Ephraim takes one way, goes the other way, puts it above the glass, and in.
They'll
wave it off, and it's a charge. You got to be kidding me. Wow.
It's Ephraim trying to do too much. There's been one complaint about Ephraim, a very talented scorer, but every once in a while, last weekend, this week, he's just been trying to do too much by himself. Pass it off. You don't need to do that. They can see you're going to drive the lane. They'll take that charge all day.
BCC's offense looking very stagnant. The three by Stewart, and he drains it. That wasn't Stewart. I'm sorry. That is
Rubens Guerrier. You're down by 21 with 10.
And that could be the straw that breaks the camel's back already in the first half. 10 minutes and 39 seconds left in the first half. 30-9. Bunker Hill just playing much more unselfish. They're moving the basketball. They get a lot of motion. They get a lot of guys moving around. Guys are getting open.
And that was a 5-point swing. That last little play right there, all done by Rubens Griffith. Rubens Guerrier. Guerrier takes the charge down low, then gets open in the corner for the open three. Take 2 points off there, add three. 5-point swing. This Bayhawks team right now needs to start shooting. They have one basket from the field.
This is a pivotal moment in the game. They can't afford to get down anymore, Andrew. They're down 30-9. They're down 21 points. You've got to start to make a little bit of a run and start to chip into this lead right now. Coming out of this timeout, BCC needs to get back into their patented press. It's something that's been so huge for them over the last several years. Their press, their athleticism, the way that they put it on teams, they need to do this right now. They have not shown that press. When they're pressing, they're at their best. When they're trapping and pressing and causing turnovers, causing havoc, getting in the passing lanes, that's when they're at their best because they're getting turnovers, they're playing together, and they get themselves in transition, and that's how they get going. And I'm surprised that Coach Rob Del Lu has not put the press on this team.
They've tried to put the press on the team, but it didn't work. They kept it. They haven't been able to defend down low. That's what's taking it all out. And now you're going to see some strong defense by the Bulldogs. They're going to run the press, and it's going to start working.
Exactly. Here comes Ray Perez. Perez out to Jarrell Gomes from the top for three. No good. That would have been huge, and he couldn't make it. Rogers up to Guerrier. Kicks it back out to Sean Miller for three. No good. Up high for the rebound, Jarrell Gomes. Gomes looking to push it up court. Gets a double. The random doubles by Bunker Hill. Gomes for three, keeps shooting, no good. Desire is there, no good.
Gomes is gonna pass that up. You're rushing it, you're just trying to take shots. I understand you're a great shooter, but that's not the time to do it right now.
I think he's just starting to press. You're down 21, regional championship game. It's your sophomore year. Driving to the hole, number 10.
Jump ball.
Jump ball. I think it's gonna stay here though.
It's gonna stay Bulldog possession. However, there's only 16 on the shot clock. Shot clock does not reset for that.
Nice defensive play by number 23, Kevin Desire. Good job to put his hand on the ball. Sean Miller. Sean Miller will come out for Bunker Hill. Number 20, Zachary Bodahu, 6'3" guard. A three-point shot, no good, in the corner by Rubens Guerrier.
These guys need to talk. That should not happen. You should have two Bayhawks going up for the same rebound and fighting for it.
Ephraim gets it down to Bing on the block. Going to his left, right. Put it up with his left, though. No good.
Is there a cover over that hoop? They cannot. They've gone more than 10 minutes and only scored one basket.
Can't buy a bucket. Ooh, nice pass into Stewart. Off the glass and in. He swoops down to the floor. And he's amped up, and his team is amped up. It is 32-9. Only 9 points. Can you believe only 9 points been mustered up by the Bayhawks so far?
That's what happens when you only hit one basket.
It's kind of unreal. Stewart makes the free throw. Another three-point play by him.
He is just picking up where he left off.
He's been the story. He's been the dominant force. He's a bulldog for sure. Ephraim being guarded by Rogers. Kicks it back out to Ray Perez. Josh Nelson. Back out to Ray Perez. Good defense by the Bulldogs. 9 on the shot clock. Got to get a good look. Got to get a good shot. Bing on the block. Puts it up. Off the glass
there
and in.
Go.
Nice move on the block. Good big man moves by Bing.
They needed that badly.
Good job for him to get position on the block and put it up off the glass and in. Three-point shot. No good.
Airballs it.
Guerrero misses that. Taking it the other way is Nelson. Little hesitation. Puts it up. No good.
How is that not coming in over the back?
Good job by Save. Ooh, goodness gracious. God, that would have been a good that would have been a good possession right there. They could have scored. They needed that. They need the hoops. Rogers dumps it in to Stewart.
The foul's on the floor. It's going to send Stewart to the line for 1-1.
Yeah, fouls before the shot, but like you said, both teams now in the bonus. So we'll be shooting free throws from here on out here in the first half.
Poor positioning there by Bing. If he's going to do that, you need to jump straight up. You can't be jumping on a backwards angle. You got to time that jump better if you want to make that stop.
Bing's going to play more discipline, Andrew. He's always leaping. He always goes for the head fake. And these Bunker Hill Bulldogs, they get the BCC Bayhawks. They get them in up in the air with their head fakes, getting them off the ground.
It's a sign of an overanxious team.
Well, right now the Bayhawks need to be overanxious. They need to be having a sense of urgency.
No, you don't. But you have a sense of urgency without being overanxious. When I say they're overanxious, every defensive saying it comes up, they're just going in for that first swipe. They're not trying to contain. You can still contain and play with a type of urgency.
They're jumping out of their shorts. It's an uphill battle right now. Bing gets it at the top of the key. Goes in. He's going to get the foul call.
That's who you want to get into foul trouble. That's his second. Get him out of the game.
That would be huge. You get that guy out of the game. Unfortunately, Bunker Hill has another few good men, if you will. Bing on the front of the 1-1. Again, another BCC miss. Got to take advantage of these little opportunities that you're having. Eight minutes left, enough time to make a little run and cut into this lead. Both free throws miss, rebounded by, who's in the game now? Aslam Adejibi. Francois gets into the lane, flips it up, no good. Bing tried to rip it away, but he couldn't. Francois comes back away with it, out the glass, no good. Loose ball.
That's a foul.
Number 35 is checked into the game for the Bulldogs. Anselm Adejbe. Another guy who's 6'5". All these guys
are tall team.
All these guys over 6 foot.
It's going to be 1-on-1. I was wondering why they were doing that. Free throws.
That's the name of the game.
It's incredible right now. 7:42 to go in the first half. Only two baskets made by the Bayhawks, and that was Nelson very early on, and then Bing about 2 minutes ago. So
you got to get some momentum.
Free throws are one way to do it.
And Nelson sinks that one. Desperately needed that. Miguel Tejada in the game for the Bayhawks, number 11. He's in there with Armani Baker, Josh Nelson at the line, number 4, number 3, Ray Perez, and number 13, Jeremiah Ephraim for the boys in green. Adejbe into number 20's Zachary Baduhu. Here comes the Bayhawks with that trap, that half-court trap. Tron Smith dumps it into the big man, Danias. They trap him, kicks it back out to number 20, Zachary Baduhu. Smith back into the big man. 7 on the shot clock. There's a charge. That's big. That's something that can get the Bayhawks going. You know what that just tells me? That the Bayhawks, they have it in them. They're not playing 100% on the defensive end.
And I don't know why. If there's a game you're going to play 100%, this has to be the game to do it. A ticket to New York is on the line, and you're sitting down 22 points.
That was our best defensive stop yet. Pick being set up by Ping. Perez going baseline. Oh, nice little move by Perez. Trying to put it over the big man. No good. Sheik is Crow.
It's going to remain Bayhawk ball beneath the basket. That's what you want to see. Now we're starting to see some intensity.
Slowly cut into this lead. Slowly do it. Big possession here. Every possession's big now. From underneath his own basket, Nelson.
Got to give it up.
Got to get it in. There's Baker trying to take it in. Nelson comes away
with
it.
There you go. Pull it out. Slow it down. Get a right shot. That's what I want to see. Stop the rush.
Don't be intimidated. Take it in. Nelson crossing over. Swoops in.
Oh, goodness gracious. Kicked it out.
They're so worried. They're so worried about it getting blocked. As they should be, but the Bunker Hill presence, their height inside, their presence inside is been debilitating for the Bayhawks, to say the least. They're making them change their shots a lot. They're making them alter their shots. So that presence being felt by the Bayhawks against Bunker Hill and their big team.
All you have to do is go up strong.
There was a lot of green there. Ephraim comes away with the steal. Nelson in transition, going in the paint, takes it up. No good.
Got to go up strong. Just going up weak, trying to make a little fancy thing.
Exactly. Going the other way, all the way, coast to coast.
That's our ball.
We got Bristol basketball. Jason Bing coming in the game to take the ball out for the Bayhawks. 35-13 here, 6 minutes and 21 seconds. If you're Coach Rob Del Lu, you want to see your Bayhawks team get this lead under 20, preferably around 14 by the end of the half. 14, 12 points, something that can be done.
You're going to be near the 10. To have a chance, you need to be near the 10 mark. If you can somehow cut this to single digits, go on a nice little run these last 6 minutes, you'll be in good
Nelson
shape for the second
baseline.
Half.
Nelson, go on baseline. Here's Ephraim being guarded by Bean. Ephraim for three, rolls out. They can't hit from the outside. Tron Griffin comes away with it.
Can't even dribble with his right hand.
Yeah, he's looking like he's in pain, but I give him all the credit in the world. Bean going to the left. It puts it up in the lane. Pretty move there by Evan Bean. Evan Bean, another guy who's 6'5" from North Quincy. 37-13. God. Perez.
That will remain Bayhawk ball beneath the basket.
Try to get Bean cut into the hole. Almost looked like a little pick and roll play they had going. But still Bayhawks basketball. Nelson to inbound from underneath his own basket. Has an open Ephraim. Deep three. No good.
Another missed.
You keep waiting for those shots to fall. They just don't fall. Going the other way. The lanky.
Right off the side of the backboard.
Trigaldi now in the game. Going back the other way, and Griffin with the steal. Number 22, Andrew Gallardi, another freshman. He goes 6'4" from Melrose High School. He's in the game for the Bulldogs. For three, Elijah Rogers, no good. Tip by Gildaldi, but into Perez's hands. Perez comes away with it, bounce pass inside to Bing, gets it knocked away by Rogers.
That's the time you pump fake it. Even if you're Bing, you have a guy coming in front of you. You got to pump fake that, let him jump over, and then you go up for it.
Is it me, or is the Bayhawks, when they're on defense, they're jumping out their shorts, and then when they're on offense, they're flat-footed because they don't do the up fakes?
They're just rushing. That's all this is. They're trying to get that first thing right off the bat, and you can't do that on the offense with an athletic team like this. That's their one weakness. That's how you can exploit a team like that. Out of bounds, turnover.
Banks turns the ball over.
That's how you exploit an athletic team. You do that pump fake download. You get them off their feet, which they are very apt to do, and then they foul you going up, and then you're in good shape.
Exactly. That's what you get to do to the big guys. Because Stewart and Freedom's Denias, they show that they will foul you. They have 10 team fouls. Perez following the basketball. There's Sean Miller for three. Nothing doing. It's going to be an air ball. Bing out to Perez. Perez into Bing. Bing goes up. And finally a basket made by BCC. Griffith, here comes the trap. Here comes that trap. Backcourt.
Oh, carry. That's a carry. Had his kind of palmed it and then brought it over.
Oh, I thought he stepped back. Backcourt.
It looked like a carry, is what the ref called.
Thank you for that. Josh Banks will come in for Miguel Tejada. Josh Banks sporting the blondish, goldish, yellowish hairdo today.
Yeah, that yesterday. The highlighter head.
Yeah, the highlighter head. Well, yesterday too. They'll get inside. Bing going up.
That's
strong.
And
gets
one.
It in. I tell you what, Jason Bing has been their emotional leader. He's the guy that's been showing the emotion.
And that's
and
the third
fire.
Foul. That's going to be the third foul charged to Danuse, which is a good sign.
Jason Bing stepping up to the line. Points for Bing. Three-point play, he sinks it. Makes the three-point play, cuts it to 19. The big man Bing saying, come on, fellas, hop on my back.
And this all happening while
Rogers
Holmes is on the bench.
Through. Puts it up off the glass and gets it to roll.
All this little run by the Bayhawks happening.
Rogers so good. Nelson back the other way,
one.
Gets it to go. Did he just do the Superman?
I think so.
I think he just did a Cam Newton. You're down by 20, guy. You shouldn't be Superman.
And that's the third foul charged to Sean Miller. Wait, Miller's not. Yeah.
I do like
just
Nelson.
Subbed out.
I do like Nelson, though. I always pass by him and speak to him, and he is a very respectful young man. Always says, how you doing? Good kid. Second leading scorer for the Bayhawks. Completes the three-point play. Maybe this will bring some kind of energy. Oh. Going for the steal, almost had it, but they're gonna call a foul.
One and one for France Francois.
I was thinking Francois.
Oh, it's Francois.
It's Francois. France Francois. I was saying Francois. Sinks the first free throw. France Francois. Guard slash forward, 6 foot three. Francois makes both free throws. Up to Nelson. Nelson for three. Good! Drains it.
That's what he needs to get going. We saw yesterday a lot of the hesitation on that three. He can pull up and hit it.
Yes, he can. When he's not hesitating, when he's making that shot and he's confident in it, he can make it.
That's what you got to do. Keep that pressure on Griffin. He'll make those mistakes. He's not feeling good. That shoulder is bugging him.
Rogers loses control, but puts it above the glass. Rebounded by Bing. Good job of Bing by keeping it up high.
How is
Big
that
man
not a jump ball, though?
Ooh, Perez going through the defense.
Just passed it right to Griffith.
Goodness gracious. You get the momentum, you get a steal, and you give it right back to Bunker Hill. Rogers taking it middle, goes strong, dips the head.
That's a block.
Block on Jason Bing. I tell you what, Rogers, when he starts getting into that second gear, and he starts getting into the lane, I mean, he's tough to stop. He'll take it right at you. That kid's got no fear.
Bing could have had the charge there, but he decided to move his feet a little bit. If he just stayed put or even get out of Rogers' way when he put his head down, you could have seen Rogers top to the floor.
Who are leading scorers for Bunker Hill?
I'll give you one guess.
Stewart.
Yeah.
I know that. That ball bounces up.
17 points for Stewart.
And how about this man right here, Mr. Elijah Rogers?
He's got seven going for eight.
Rogers makes both free throws. We've seen the difference that this kid makes. When he went out for those couple minutes against BCC last week in the MCCAC championship game, the state championship game, Bunker Hill looked out of sorts a little bit. But when he's back on the court, I mean, he makes the thing go round and round. Perez, nice move to his left, puts that up. And couldn't get it to drop.
Two shots. But you keep getting these fouls, and they will add up, and then that'll change the way they have to play. Because once these guys start getting into foul trouble, then they can't be as aggressive as they have been on these blocks.
Both teams in the double bonus with 2 minutes and 41 seconds left to play in the first half from Springfield. First free throw made. Perez has been a good little bench player, a good little point guard, backup point guard coming in off the bench for Coach Rob Del Lue. Sinks both free throws.
And all this little scoring spree done by the Bayhawks has been done with their leading scorer on the bench.
Surprisingly enough, they're going to need him. They're going to need him to loom large in the second half. Ooh, Perez. Didn't look like he knew what he wanted to do with that. Nelson looking to push. In transition. Goes up. Puts it up off the glass. No good.
Trying to rush it a little bit, Nelson there.
Gave him a little head nod, but couldn't get it off the glass. Rogers, hard to his right. Charge. Going Greenway.
No matter how many years I've done play-by-play for basketball games at any level, I will never get to understand the fine line between a block and a charge. It is such a fine
line.
Well,
a charge, you want to have both feet.
Yeah, I know you're going to
be both feet set.
But sometimes it's all about when they're set, too. Alex Cotton.
The charge is in the eye of the beholder. Another turnover by the Bayhawks. Going back the other way. Getting that gear. Little floater in the lane. Gets it to go. Bulldog just imposing their will against Bayhawks right now.
You got to get this lead down to 15 by half.
Nelson for three. Side rim. Rebounded by Cotton.
Nice pass off. There we go.
Nice. That's the guy that takes it strong. That's the guy that takes it strong right there, Armani Baker.
That's exactly what you want to see if you're the Bayhawks. Smart passes to get to that Baker open lane to make the easy layup. Draws the foul, going to the line, shooting two. Now you got to make them.
I want to see more of Armani Baker getting the ball on the block, getting the ball where he likes it, near the baseline, taking it strong, going to the free throw line. I want to see more. I like to see more Jason Bain getting the ball on the block and letting him do something out there. Let the ball run through these guys sometimes.
It's going to be interesting to see what with Jarrell Gomes is going to happen in the second half.
Well, I'll tell you what, he's well rested right now. Second free throw missed. Every point counts. Here's Tron Smith. Number two, number one, Elijah Rogers. Number one and number two guard, respectively. And those are their numbers. They'll dump it in. Inside to the big man. Loses control of it. No good. That's a JB. Loose ball foul, and it's going to be on Nelson.
His second.
Franz Francois at the line. First free throw is a made free throw by Franz Francois. He can extend the lead back to 20 for the Bulldogs. Now a 19-point lead, or a 20-point lead, assuming he makes his free throw, it's not insurmountable, but it feels insurmountable right now. That's the way this game is going. Second free throw missed. Going back BCC's way. It would be a long trip back to Fall River if they lose this game.
It's always going to be a long trip after a loss, but right now what you guys have to do is you got to go into this half, cut this lead down.
But when you're... I never seen so many free throws missed these last couple weekends like we've seen this weekend, Andrew. I tell you, it's been epic.
Miss after miss.
Both free throws missed by Cotton. Under a minute to play here in the first half. Hope you're with us here on FR Media. We're streaming live. Also, this game will be broadcasted on Comcast, Channel 95, Fall River Community Television in the coming days. Down inside. Rogers getting through the zone
jump
there.
Ball.
Going to be a jump ball.
Jump ball.
Going Bristol way.
Making things happen slowly but surely. They're starting to get the defensive stops now, but they're just not scoring still.
Offensively inept. We talked about them playing a lot of isolation basketball, not moving the basketball around, being unselfish. Need to get something going to the basket. Oh, Rogers in the passing lane. Goes up. And he's going to go to the line. Gets knocked to the floor. Tried to scoop it up with his left hand, couldn't get it, but he's going to the free throw line anyway. So Elijah Rogers will step to the line for two.
Very nice stroke there by Rogers. Got that technique down, finds what works for him, and makes it happen.
I'll tell you what, this is such a solid all-around basketball player, this Elijah Rogers kid. Rogers sinks both free throws. BCC will hold for the last shot here with the first half. It's Ray Perez. Ray Perez looking, he's holding on to it too long. Banks forced up a three, no good. Rebounded by Bean. Rogers, no. Not sure if that would have counted or not, but either way, it would not have counted. So either way, the Bayhawks find themselves down 21 points, 48-27. Bunker Hill has the lead at the half. All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Springfield Technical Community College here in Springfield, Massachusetts, where the Bristol Community College Bayhawks trail the MCCAC champion Bunker Hill Community College Bulldogs 48-27 as the teams walk back on the court, getting ready for the second half here. I'm here with the infamous Double A, Andrew Augusta. Andrew, not a way you want to start off a championship game, trailing 48-27, getting dominated in the paint. Andrew, what needs to change if this team can even make a run at it? How does that happen? I know that's your... No. I just said it earlier. It's 48-27. That's 21. I know that's your fuzzy math going, but... If the cameraman can swing the camera back over here this way... I'm going to point that... I just wanted to point out that it's T-shirt time here in Springfield. T-shirt time. I And do we have a few of the leading scorers? The leading scorers are for the...
David Stewart, 17. Elijah Rodgers, 12. Those are two leading away from the Bulldogs. Leading for your Bayhawks, you have Jason Finch and Josh Nelson.
And if you're the Bayhawks, you're a team that averages close to 86 points per game throughout the season, one of the higher scored teams in Region 21. This has to be one of their lowest scoring in outputs for a half this year. It's got to be. Been a rough first half, but a 21-point lead is not insurmountable. What we need to see from BCC is to have one of those halves like last week when they played Northern Essex in the semifinal game in the MCCAC tournament. They show that they can get stops. Well, you get to switch something up. I don't agree with having Jerome Gomes, your best player, one of the best players in the country, one of the best scorers in the country. I don't agree with him being on the bench. This could be his last game in the green and white. Of course he's out there. I like to see Bing out with this group. Well, that's why he's over there in the suit over there. And we're over here. So here we go. Second half underway. Regional championship on the line. Both teams, they're starting five out there. Danias from the corner, no good. And they're going to call a foul on Josh Nelson? On Alex Cotton away from the basketball? Man. He's giving up a lot of size. Stewart in the lane, drops, no, can't get it to go. Rebounded by Nelson. Ooh, Nelson, out of control, but falls back, trades it. Nelson looked haywire there, but got the fadeaway jumper in the lane. Got to play inspired, spirited basketball here, the Bayhawks. Got to give it your all. In the corner for three, it's good. Number 14, Evan Bean. He led the game off with a three. He leads the second half with a three. That's Evan Bean. Nelson, cross-court pass to Jarrell Gomes. Gomes up to Baker at the top. Baker going underneath. Strong move. Strong move on the big sophomore forward, Freedom Zanias. You talk about going strong. Look at that strong move going up against a 6'8" guy. They'll dump it in to Stewart, off the glass and in. David Stewart, the big emotional leader for the Bulldogs, and he's going to the line again for another chance at a three-point play. Stewart gets his own free throw, gets his own rebound, puts it up off the glass, ends up being a four-point play, four-point turnaround. If you're going to foul the Bulldogs, foul them. Knock them on their butts. Gomes wills his way, gets it to the lane, can't get it to roll. Going to stay Bayhawks basketball. You're not going to win with Jarrell Gomes scoring 0 points, that's for sure. Nelson at the top of the key, looking to drive against Rogers from the elbow, jumper, no good. Over the back is Freedom's Denis. It's going to be a foul on number 11. Freedom's Denis, he sat most of that first half on the bench. That's what's going to happen. Number four, France. I'm going to say it like this. France Francois. Does that sound more like it? Jarrell Gomes into Bing. Nice inbound play, and Bing puts it up off the glass and in. He'll go to the line. BCC needs to come out and play their best half. They got to play their best half of the whole year. And Bing. Bing with the three-point play. Draining that free throw. And the Bulldogs, they are walking the ball up the court. Here comes a trap. They'll lob it in. Yes, sir. And they're looking for an alley-oop, trying to get an alley-oop to Stewart. Had to get it pinned against the backboard. Rogers thought about it. Now flips it up and drains it. Rogers loves that little floater in the lane. That's a high percentage shot for him. He gets it to fall. Nelson inside to Bing. Guarded by Stewart on the block. Knocked away by Francois. Coming away with it is Stewart. Ooh, Rogers loses it, and then he fouls Ephraim. Ephraim was off to the races if he didn't do that, so. Man, 57-34. If you told me this was going to be the score, Andrew, in the second, early on here in the second half, I would have told you you're a liar. Taliban. They need to get it down to 12 or 10 by the 10-minute mark. Halfway through, they need to get it down to at least 12, 10 points to have a realistic shot at having this. They need to make a run. They can do it. Number 2 seed in Region 21. You got to take the fight to the Bulldogs right now. The Bulldogs don't have to take the fight to you anymore. They got the big lead. Nelson thought about kicking it back out. Now he gets it blocked by Stewart. Loose ball. Cotton coming away with it. Back up to Gomes. Gomes for three. Air ball. But Nelson is there to clean it up and put it off the glass. I'm sure Gomes will say so. For BCC, you got to go there and pressure the basketball. That's what Ephraim's doing. Ooh, Rogers, how did Stewart come away with that? Loose ball. Rogers gets it down inside. Coming away with it. This guy is just eating up down low. Take him away. They can't do it. That's the story. David Stewart. Unbelievable player. Oh, caught a nice pass to Bing inside. Can't get it. Got to go. Rogers. Oh, nice block. Nice challenge by Gomes. Gets the block. But Rogers comes away with it. Being in the corner for three. He likes that corner shot, and he banks it. And you hate to talk about dagger shots, dagger threes, with 16 minutes to play in the second half of a championship game, but that could be it. Goodness gracious. Nothing going the Bayhawks' way. Nelson trying to challenge, and he makes it. That's a big three. Nelson, too worried about styling and profiling like he's a nature boy or something. You gotta get back in this game. You're down by 23 points. I do understand that, but Frank Hoy dribbles and bibbles, puts it up off the glass and in. A lot of strong big fellows for the Bulldogs, that's for sure. 25-point lead. We're a live streamer from Springfield. Springfield Technical Community College. Cotton at the elbow, but gets it down into Bing. Bing again. Bing looks just so flat-footed. Oh, swooping to the hoop as Mr. Elijah Rogers lays that in. Here comes Gomes. Coming in. Nice pass to Bing, but he can't hold on to it. Knocked away by Rogers. Rogers going the distance. Kicks it back to Stewart. Stewart the trailer. Get a timeout, Coach D. Get a timeout. 68-39. BCC getting blown out of here. Goodness gracious. I just don't see the enthusiasm right now. I don't see the effort. I don't see the fire by BCC right now. Like, what are they doing? I see them smiling over there sometimes. I see them styling and profiling on shots when you're down by 30. You know, I don't know what's going on over there. It's almost like they're kind of, you know, giving this game away. Almost like they're conceding this game to Bunker Hill. Like, okay, you got us. I mean, come on. You had a shot at this thing. You were down by 21 at the half. If you're Jarrell Gomes, you got to take this basketball game over. Followed by Rogers. Yeah. Bunker Hill in a 2-3 zone now. Tejada gets it into Bing. Bing. But Bing doesn't have the legs right now. He's getting all these easy opportunities down low, and he can't connect. He can't connect on any of them. It's ridiculous. He's got the height. He's got the strength. He doesn't have the strength in his legs right now. Bing looked to jump it in. Looked to dump it in. It was a good idea. It was a good play set up, but overthrew Baker. Again, a lot of time here, but Francois is trying. Here's the one-handed Tron Griffith, and they're going to take a timeout. They should be dominating him right now. He's beating you with one hand tied behind his back, literally, right now. All right, so we're taking a break. We're taking a timeout here from Springfield Technical Community College, 68-39. Bunker Hill on top of BCC. You know, with the second half of the season that BCC has had, it's going to be, a tremendous disappointment for that group, for as well as they played. They really turned it up a notch, because they were really a team in the first half of the season trying to find their way, kind of scuffling around the 500 mark, and they really took off after the Christmas break. Won 11 straight going into the state tournament last weekend. They didn't lose one time after Christmas break. So for January and February, basically undefeated, suffered their first loss last Sunday in the championship game against this same Bunker Hill team. This would be a disappointing end to the season. This has been a great group, close-knit group of guys. I was at the team hotel last night. Looked like a team that was very loose, maybe a little bit too loose. Can't play scared, that's for sure. Tron Griffith going to his left. The only way he can go. Misses it. Franz Francois with the basketball. They'll dump it in to the big man, Stewart, inside. No good this time. Baker with the rebound. Jarrell Gomes pulls up for three. Gets it, finally. They only say two, foot on the line. Boy, if he can get it going, it'll be huge. Going the other way, where's the defense on that one? Where's the defense? Zachary Vadahu driving all the way to the hole for a layup. Baker going to the baseline, takes it at, gonna be charged. Takes it at Stewart with the position. Baker likes that baseline move, dives into Stewart. Baker finds himself in foul trouble again in a championship setting, as he was last weekend. Again, Guerrero going all the way up the basket. Is he invisible? Just really frustrating. When you look at this BCC team and what they've accomplished this year, not given quite the effort that we're used to seeing. And you think there would be a sense of urgency. You think Coach Rob Del Lue would implement this press, which has been successful. Gomes for three, finally. Back-to-back baskets, nearly two threes made by Jarrell Gomes. The shot wasn't falling for Jarrell Gomes. I think he can finally get a sense of urgency. Ball goes out of bounds. Little by little, you can crawl back into this thing. 12:28 to play. Maybe get Bunker Hill resting back on their heels a little bit. Here's Ray Perez. Jarrell Gomes time. Jarrell Gomes for three. Oh, off the side of the rim. That would have been huge. Ooh, that ball. That was Hail Mary knocked away by Nelson. Nelson with a big safety play there. Perez not scared. Going to the hole. Gets a block, though. Stewart on the other end. Just him and Gomes. That's got to be a charge. That's a charge. Goodness gracious. I give Jarrell Gomes credit for taking that charge by the big man. You've seen that coming the whole way. How many fouls on Mr. Stewart now? So three fouls. Denius with four fouls. The two big men. The two biggest men. Oh, they get it inside to Desire. Desire back out to Gomes. Gomes turns around. Puts up three. Can't get it to go. No foul. Goodness gracious. That's going to be another charge. Another charge. This time they charge it to Francois. Those are two charges that we've seen coming. Like, out charge. That's it. So that's the definition of a charge right there, Andrew. Inside to Bing. Bing strong. There's finally. Yes. Bing with a little bump there and gets it off the glass to go. Little mini run here by the Bayhawks. They need to go out and get that basketball. Gomes covering Bean. Need to get a couple stops now. Francois crosses over on Desire. Takes it to the hole. Off the glass and in. Nice take by Francois. Just when BCC gets going, Barker Hill goes right back. Nice crossover move by Perez. Perez breaking ankles. Bing from the elbow. Likes that shot. No good. Jumper for three. Front rims it. Rebounded by Nelson. Nelson getting it going. Nelson takes it in. Swoops to the hoop. No good. Ooh, Perez thought about it. Didn't want to pull the trigger. Nelson for three. Off the side of the rim. No good.
Keep it in. There we
Ooh,
go.
Try to throw it off of Desire, but it stays in bounds. Here's Jarrell Gomes. Needs to go to the hole. Start getting into the hole. Loses the basketball.
That's a foul on Gomes.
Haven't seen Jarrell Gomes this flustered in a while. Since the beginning of the season. Down by 25 with 10 minutes and 12 seconds to play. 16 fouls for Bunker Hill, 14 fouls for BCC. Perez covering Griffith up the court. Perez all over Griffith with his one hand. Steven Gonzalez, number five, is checked in for the Bayhawks now. Evan Smith slips through past Bing.
That's the fourth foul on Gomes.
Four fouls on Jarrell Gomes now with nearly 10 minutes to play.
Two shots coming up.
Evan Bean sinks the first one. We were here for the women's final earlier today between Roxbury. Roxbury came out on top against Gateway Community College. Roxbury wins another regional championship. They're going to the Nationals. And big difference between that game and this game. That game seemed like a very, very spirited, you know, high energy, high intensity contest. The crowd really getting into it. This kind of a laid back crowd, although it is a 27 point lead too. And that free throw made, the Bayhawks will take a timeout with 9:54 left to play here in Springfield. 74-47. Any hope for the Bayhawks?
There's always hope. I mean, if there's a complete collapse on one side and the BayHawks just don't miss a shot the rest of the way. But that's really what it's going to take to win this game. I mean, you have to give a lot of credit to Bunker Hill right now, showing up strong, fast, athletic, a very talented team. And it's just it's what happens. You might be the hot team coming in, get that winning streak, but once you run into a buzzsaw like the Bulldogs, they'll cut anything in front of you, and that's the way it's working. They're using their bigs to their advantage. They just don't have an answer. And the one thing that I'd like to see the BayHawks try to do for here is stopping the big man down low. Every time they're trying to pass it down low, they're trying to intercept the pass by going in front. Let that pass come in. Stand your ground. Stand tall. Let them charge you.
They teach you to put your hands up. Put
Let
your hands up on defense.
Let them charge you on the way back in.
That's it. Shuffle your feet and use your body when you're playing defense. Put your hands up in the air. Instead of trying to reach around, like you said, going for steals. Just not happening when you're playing against these big guys. Bunker Hill with so many big athletic guys, too. I think Coach Rob Del Lue in the offseason needs to go out and recruit some athletic big men, something that he's lacked last couple seasons. Jarrell Gomes trying to drive against his zone. Swoop it up and in. Rebounded by Gonzalez. And there will be a foul on the play. Josh Nelson, a lot of times, has a lot of quickness, has a lot of good dribble moves, can get to the basket, just has a hard time finishing a lot of times. A lot of times he's trying to scoop it up and under.
That's his size. He's a little undersized to be trying to drive the lane. But he can work the point really well. I think if you had a 1-2-3 with Nelson at the 1, Ephraim at the 2, and Gomes at the 3, you could do some strong damage, but not against a team that's this big.
Well, last year you weren't here, but I think BCC has, this year, they've lacked a true point guard. Last year and in the last couple years, BCC had a point guard by the name of Malcolm Moniz, who was a floor general, similar to Elijah Rogers, picked his spots when he had to shoot, was very efficient with the basketball, was a great facilitator, someone that was in charge, someone that was the number one guy, the guy that the offense ran through, made a lot of great decisions. That's something that they've lacked this year, is having a guy like Malcolm Moniz. They really missed him.
And we have a foul. His first. Charged.
Bunker Hill. Bunker Hill will inbound from beneath their own basket. Sharon Griffith will inbound for the Bulldogs. Inbounds to Francois. Ooh, Perez on the exchange. Almost looked like he was going to steal that one. Francois buckling down on Nelson. Turns around, out the glass, over Bing, out the glass and in. 29-point lead. It's been all Bulldogs.
Since the opening tip.
Tejada gets it down to Perez. This is the ball movement we wanted to see. Nelson for three, gets it to go.
It's amazing. When they move the ball, they seem to score. I've been calling for that for the past 2 weeks.
Finally, that's what we want to see. Get the ball moving. That's the team that we're used to seeing.
That's going to be Nelson's third.
Both teams are in the one-on-ones now. Both teams are in the bonus. Both teams with 17 fouls each.
Checking in for the BayHawks, Baker. He's got 4 fouls.
Josh Banks looks like he's going to check into the game. Ephraim is out. Crowd trying to get a little stomp in. That stomp sounded like a bunch of little ponies. not like a herd of buffalo. You know what I'm saying? Goodness gracious. That's all I've been saying all day long. It's been one of those days. Second free throw missed. Here comes Josh Nelson pushing up court. Thought about three. Nice hesitation move. Puts it up. And he's going to get the foul. Nice little move by Nelson. Looked like he was going up for three. Little hesitation.
Nice little head fake there by Nelson. A little stutter step, but to keep the dribble going so he doesn't get caught to travels. Very smart move.
Yeah, and put it into high gear, second gear.
Nelson, another sophomore. Hits the first.
Yeah, now Josh Nelson, Sherrill Gomes, both sophomore sensations for this team. They'll both be graduating this spring, so those two guys will be taking off. Josh Nelson sinks those two free throws. Steven Gonzalez, another sophomore. Was honored for his academics acumen earlier this month in the final BCC home game at Bishop Conley in Fall River, next to the BCC campus. BCC, matched up man, taking up the court is Francois, Sean Miller, loose ball. That's the defense you want to see. Here comes Nelson. Tejada into Baker. Baker off the glass and in. Score it. Baker caught the big man mid-jump and somehow got it over him to put it in. Armani Baker. Telling you the best little big man they got. The best big man they got. Baker can't get the three-point play.
Too anxious, Nelson.
Would have cut it to 22 if he had made it. Got to have a sense of urgency. Got to get some turnovers now.
I'm still surprised the Bulldogs have Griffith in. You should be resting him. Let
on
him get
the
that
block.
Shoulder.
Turnaround, no good. Adishibi with the miss. Nelson, another stop and go. Gets it to the lane. Too many steps.
Eventually that was going to get called.
Had it going, but. Ray Perez on Griffith. Now here comes a trap. Where was this game plan all game?
Even though, but you also got to look at the game plan, yes. Something you'd like to see, and it probably could have caused some more fits.
I'll never understand it.
Also, if you're going to run that, you need to have a team that is high energy, very well in shape, that can withstand putting up a full court press like that, putting all the pressure, putting the throw down. And that's how the teams who can.
But it's something that they've done. This is what they do. This is what makes them a good team is that press and causing havoc with it. Baker going baseline, flips it up, no good.
And we got an offensive
Bunker
foul.
Hill way. Going Bunker Hill way.
Second foul charge to Banks.
Hill 77-54. And we're going to play the free throw game now. Is
it's too early for that. Come on. Just let them play. Let the clock run.
It's going to be dark out when we're driving home now. No, it's about a 5:40 sunset these days.
Yeah, getting closer to 6, 7 o'clock.
17 days before before the sun sets at 7:01.
Let the countdown begin.
First free throw made by Mr. Bean. Second free throw made by Mr. Bean. 79-54. Jarrell Gomes, call him all world, all nation. Cross court pass to Perez. Gomes, Nelson loses control of it. Leap pass out to Nelson, over to Bean. And Mr. Bean will go back to the line. BCC just way overmatched.
That was a technical.
Was a technical foul on Jarrell Gomes? That's Terrell Gomes fifth.
That is his fifth.
He's fifth, so he's gone. And his career as a Bayhawk.
So I think it's a foul and a technical.
Foul and a technical, so down by 25. The hopes of becoming a regional champion, Region 21 champion, advancing to the national tournament in New York, waning. And you can see the frustration. You can see the little bit of the disappointment on the sideline.
And then now what you'll see.
And you hate to see, you know, a great player like Jarrell Gomes go out that way, fouling out, going to the bench. Sad to see, but Jarrell Gomes is a great player. It's been a great 2 years at BCC, so your heart goes out to a kid like that.
Second shot good.
Was having headset drama. Headset problems. Oh, goodness gracious. Where do we go from here? 82 to 54, 7 minutes and 12 seconds left in the second half in the game, actually. 82 to 54, 28-point lead for the Bulldogs. Bulldogs looking to advance to the Nationals, and it looks like that's what they're going to do. They are the MCC-AC champions, looking to back that up, being the Region 21 champions. They're going to have all that hardware going into New York, going into big New York. So, and they know that they know that they have this one in hand. It's a shame to say.
Yeah, no, the one thing that the Bulldogs have never done, they've never taken their foot off the gas. And even when their non-starters have been in, they've been keeping that momentum.
That.
This is a deep team, and it's a talented team. And it's great to see it, because this is going to be a team that could make a deep run in the Nationals. It'll be fun to follow them.
They are a deep team. And like you said, not only are they a deep team, I mean, all those guys on the bench are they're freshmen. These guys will be coming back next year. They're going to have a strong team. And they're all very talented. Perez for three, no good. Going over the back to get that one is Francois. No foul call there. Whiff swallowed their whistle. Here's Sean Miller trying to get it over the timeline. Loses it back over the timeline. Front and back. Back court. Violation.
Dribble it right off his foot. That was an obvious one.
Yes. 6 minutes, 52 seconds remaining in this. Both teams near the double bonus. Here's Ray Perez. Banks for three. Rolls out. The basketball gods not on BCC side here. Baker doing the dirty work as he does with the rebound. He'll go to the line for two. And now both teams are in the double bonus, so they'll be shooting two from here on out. Doesn't mean a whole heck of a lot right now, as it would mean in a close game.
Got to make these free throws still. I mean, you got to start looking at some positives here. And one positive is you can start working on free throws, get ready for next year. I mean, the Bayhawks are returning a lot of players. About half their roster will be back next year.
There is a lid on that basket, I'm sure of it. There's an invisible lid on that basket. Bean driving to his right.
Nice that ball tip away that by ball, Baker.
That ball deflected, yes. You know, and you say that, you know, you want to take positive, especially when it comes to collegiate athletics. And yes, they are returning a lot of guys, but they're losing a couple of key guys, a couple big scorers. One of the leading scorers in the nation is Jarrell Gomes, Josh Nelson, their second leading scorer. That ball tipped by Perez. Perez bringing it back the other way. The little man, he'll go to the line. No fear. Oh my God, you're winning by 27 points.
That is a foul out, I believe.
Oh my goodness.
On
and you're right.
Anselm Edgeby, that
bunker,
is his fifth.
Bunker,
oh no, that charge was charge number 14. Excuse me.
Bunker Hill, you're right. You're right, Andrew. Bunker Hill has not taken their foot off the gas in any of these games, and neither are their fans. I mean, they're up by 27, and they're begging for foul calls.
One thing I think is a shining moment is going to be right here with Perez. Could be a big factor next year, freshman coming back. And he could be someone who can run the point next year. I see him being versatile enough. He can get that nice touch when needed and can actually control a contest at the point and be a true point guard next year for this Bayhawk team.
Speaking of one shining moment, are we going to play one shining moment when this game is done? One shining moment. Loose ball on the court. Tejada going to the lane.
Just
no
rushing
good.
It around, throwing it up. Wide open.
Basket
down low.
Hanging. The slam by Anselm
Edgeby,
the freshman. Nelson for three. Nice rotation. Can't get it to fall. Lid still in the basket for the Bayhawks. That was Edgeby on the other end with a slam. 6'5" from Dorchester Academy.
Nice steal there. Still playing hard is Gonzalez.
Well, that's what you want to see if you're Rob Del Lu. Perez scats through everybody. Loses control of it. Kicks it back out to Nelson. This is Nelson's game now. Nelson's team now. Put it up.
Oh,
left.
What a block.
Goodness gracious. Another block by Anselm Edgeby.
6'5 freshman. That kid's going to be an animal next
year.
Yes,
he is. Francois, this is no defense there. BCC has given up.
A big second half for Bean.
Nelson for three. No good. Rebounded by Steven Gonzalez. This guy, Francois to the hole. How do you stop that guy? Bean is there. Nobody boxing out. Nobody caring. Nelson around the back. Nelson puts it up and drains it. Puts up the floater. And again, we were talking about positives. BCC last couple years has been to this game. They've been to the regionals. They've constantly, over the last few years, have been a top team in Region 21. They're much like the Patriots. When the Patriots get to the AFC Championship game and they can't get over the hump, it's a big, huge disappointment. We expect championships from our teams, and a team that has been as good as consistent as the Patriots, even making it back to the AFC Championship game, is just not enough. You keep coming back to this game and losing, it starts to take a toll on you. You got to get over the hurdle. You got to get over the hump, and you got to find the players to do it. Banks from the wing for three, gets it to go. Must be the hair.
His first points of the day.
Needed to see more of that today. But all around, BCC has given a great effort. All jokes aside, they've given a great effort all season long. Down low,
what
Stewart.
A block
nice
by
block
Bing.
By Bing. Have some pride. Banks has pride. Gets it to Baker. Lays it in transition. Armani Baker. One kid that does have pride. 86-63. Rogers getting double teamed in the sideline over there now. Picked up by Bing.
Throws it away.
Bing running the point now. Bing should have been running the point all day. Nice pass out to Perez. Back to Bing. Can't get
and
it to fall.
Rebound.
Nice defense there by Freedom Zanias. You know, with the Bulldogs ball movement, they sometimes look like the Harlem Globetrotters up there. They're constantly just moving.
It's not even that, though. If you watch a lot of the basketball games, everyone's constantly moving. They're not doing anything particularly flashy. They're just moving the ball around, which is great. They are a great
Nelson
team.
Nelson for a deep three.
The big difference
don't even
is
know
that
if hit the rim.
The big difference is that the Bulldogs are playing much more like a team. They're passing it around, getting that open shot, making it all work.
Well, you're exactly right. Here comes Banks. Banks, where's he been all day? He's like a scoring machine out there now. Driving the lane and dropping it in. They needed someone like that to attack the basket all day long. Approaching 3 minutes to play here. Region 21 championship game. The Bulldogs looking to move on to New York. Here's Stewart. Stewart brings it back out.
Ooh, almost stolen there by Banks.
Loose ball.
And that's a block on Perez.
Tough day.
That's like the first time I think all day I've seen one player just try to take a team on by himself, and then the coach, I thought he was taking him out.
Number five, a guy whose name we really haven't said too much all day, C.J. McIntosh, another freshman, 5'10", from Boston Day and Evening Academy. Boston Day and Evening Academy. First free throw made by Mr. C.J. McIntosh. Coach Nkrumah Jones. I don't know if I'm saying that. Nkrumah Jones. He uses a lot of these players. I mean, the only guy I don't think we've seen today is Mr. Andrew William, a freshman guard, 6'1", from Malden High School. That's one name I haven't seen or haven't remember saying for sure. Deep three by Banks. No good. Rebounded by Perez. It's a three-point show, and he gets it to go. Score that up for Mr. Ray Perez.
And they just throw it out of bounds.
I know. BCC put a little pressure on, and that ball's thrown out of bounds.
Maybe they can get it within 20.
It is 20. 88-68.
So get it within, inside 20.
Oh, within, okay. Banks tees it up for three. No good. Denise Hyatt for the rebound. All 6'8" of them.
Travel.
Two minutes and 27 seconds to go. Ooh, getting inside. Nelson, up.
That's a lot of contact.
No good. Cleaning it up is Baker.
That's a foul.
No good. Baker on the floor. Loose.
Jump ball. And it's going to be Bayhawks possession.
I love the hustle. I love the hustle of Armani Baker. Diving on the floor. 2 minutes and 14 seconds left. Your team down by 20 in a championship game. And he's still hustling, diving on the floor for the basketball. That's something that you like to see. Banks will inbound for BCC.
Just going to put 24 on the shot clock.
Ooh, you've seen that coming all the way. Elijah has the wherewithal to keep it in bounds. Then he gets fouled. Rogers steals the inbound pass. Almost seen it coming the whole way. He read it the whole way. And he's going to go to the free throw line. Great wherewithal to keep that ball in bounds as he was going out to the basketball there after he had tipped it away. Kind of an anticlimactic game here today. 88-68. The Bulldogs sealing the deal. Never mind.
Sign sealed delivered. There you go.
Sign sealed delivered. That's one of my that was one of my sayings too. One of my sign sealed delivering. A trip to New York. Spinning in the lane. Nice move by Nelson. Nelson gets his own rebound, tips it up and in.
A big day for Nelson. A great first half, an even stronger second half.
He's been their only offense. Another guy who we haven't seen in a long time, Andrew, is as Rogers gets through the whole defense of BCC, gets into the lane. Another guy we haven't seen in a long time is Jeremiah Ephraim. What happened to Jeremiah Ephraim today?
He has gotten one free throw.
Jeremiah Ephraim, the freshman, one of the leading scorers for BCC. Like I said, it's the Triple J's. When you think of BCC and their offense, it's Jarrell Gomes, number one, Josh Nelson, and Jeremiah Ephraim. Jeremiah Ephraim has been sitting the whole afternoon. I wonder what happened there. He's not in foul trouble. He's not hurt that we know of. He's been on the end of that bench all day long. You get to think, what was said? What did he do? Why is he in that doghouse right now? We have no idea. Elijah Rogers sinks both free throws, and it's a 92-70 lead. Bulldogs are going to New York.
Yeah, it's tough to drop 22 in a minute 47.
That's for sure. Perez way on the window. Rebounded by Bing, puts it up and in. Yeah, even the, one of the most optimistic people, you know, can't put that in their minds. Miracles can happen, but.
That is the fourth foul on Nelson.
I don't think the Bayhawks could score 20 points in a minute 33 seconds if the Bulldogs went on the sideline and sat down. I really don't think so.
They'd have to at least put two on the court so you could inbound it, but. I think they could.
I don't think they could. First free throw made. Second free throw missed by Guerrero. Sophomore from Somerville High School, 5'11". Nelson out to Cotton. Swings it around to Banks. In the corner, Perez shoots. No good. Fighting for it is Cotton to put it up. He'll miss also, but he'll stay right here.
Not giving up. You got to give the Bayhawks credit for that. Even being down as big of a lead as they are, not giving up one bit.
And that's the thing. Even when you're down, you get to show some pride. They get it underneath to Cotton. He's held. Held by Guerrero. And Cotton will go to the line, and you can just see the energy has just been sucked out of the Bayhawks in the last, especially in the last 10 minutes of this half. The life
for three tonight, Cotton from the charity stripe.
What are the free throw numbers? Do we have the? Can we tally the free throw numbers for BCC, because it's been utterly pathetic.
That's not as bad as you think. It's better than what it was last week, I can tell you that much.
Well, it seems like it's like 50%. They'll make
it
one.
It is 50%.
They'll
it
miss
more
one.
Than, it is more than 50%, and the big factor to do with that is Josh Nelson hitting 5 for 5, and Perez hitting 5 out of 6.
But I'd like to see how many misses they have. They're down 20. How many misses? Free throw missed by number 23.
Not on the roster.
Not even on the roster. Are you serious? We haven't seen him all day. Number 23, the infant. Misses both free throws. So he'll remain off the score sheet. Perez. Oh, gets that one punched away. Gomes in the corner. Nelson in the corner for three. Swoop.
Have yourself a day, Josh Nelson. Over 20 points.
Going one way, going the other. Number 23, Mr. Score Sheet. Off the score sheet, misses that one. Perez. Out to Banks for three. No good. Rebound is Cotton. Misses it. Number 23 again. Going up, gets it blocked by Jason Bing. And he'll go to the line again, number 2-3.
They're going to see the line change coming in. A lot of the, it looks like it's are these all freshmen checking in? Desire, Stopka, the only upperclassmen checking in. It's all freshmen coming in right now.
I think the line change should have came much earlier.
Are they going to leave Perez in? If they leave Perez in, it's all freshmen on there. Or is it Banks that's going to stay? No, they're going to go. We're going with an all-freshman lineup to finish it out.
I think this is the smallest lead that Bunker Hill has had in a while, 93-76. It's been over 20 this whole half.
These are the five freshmen on the roster for the Bayhawks. In
this is going to be the future. This is going to be the nucleus of this team next year. Guys like Kevin Desire, Ray Perez, Jeremiah Ephraim.
There's one Bulldog down there, and he still gets the rebound.
Armani Baker over into the corner. Stopka gets that blocked. Blocked by Guerrero.
And that is a foul on Baker.
19 seconds to play.
And that's his fifth.
They should say when the game is like, when the basketball game is like a 20-point lead,
someone's gonna go in. Who's going in?
that there should be, and it's like under 5 minutes, there should be no more free throws. Or under 2 minutes.
Gonzalez coming in.
Kind of like a mercy rule. That free throw drained by Rubens Guerrero. How many points for Guerrero on the day?
A grand total of 4.
Grand total of 4. But he's constantly just been in there. A lot of minutes for Guerrero today. He'll get both free throws to go. 97-76.
That is Andrew William. 23 is Andrew William.
Alrighty then. Desire for 3. Gets it.
Nope, only for 2. Foot on the line.
Well, these guys like to style and profile. That's going to be it. As time runs off the clock here from Springfield Technical Community College, the Bulldogs are going to New York. The Bunker Hill Community College Bulldogs are the kings of Region 21. The final score from Springfield Technical Community College, the Bunker Hill Community College Bulldogs 97, your Bristol Community College Bayhawks 78. Stay tuned soon for the trophy presentation for the Region 21. And also for the regional tournament, a player of the tournament for Region 21. As these two teams congratulate each other in Bunker Hill, I mean, they just imposed their will all day. On the interior, just had too much size. Bunker Hill showing that they're a better team. They've won 3 out of 4 contests now against BCC. So BCC has nothing to really hang their heads about. You know, they faced Bunker Hill 3 times in the last month. They did win early on in February, but the last 2 weekends, I mean, they've really had it taken to them by the Bulldogs. And the Bulldogs are excited, as they should be. They're going to be a force to be reckoned with, as you said, Andrew. Going into that tournament in a couple weeks in New York, they're going. And your Bristol Community College Bayhawks, their future's bright. Guys like Jeremiah Ephraim, Josh Banks, Kevin Desire. You know, they are... They're going to be a team to be reckoned with. Wow.
I mean, have yourself a day, Josh Elson. 29 points, an incredible second half, scoring 19 and really lighting it up on the scoreboard.
And if we can get some of the leading scorers from both teams. Leading scorer for BCC, Josh Nelson.
He's the game-leading scorer.
He's the game-leading scorer.
Game
he's
leading
also
29.
It's going to be exciting for Bunker Hill. The season starts, the practices starts, the training camp starts in October, and then playing, try the long bus rides, the different schools, coming to a place like Springfield, going to a place like Fall River, you know, going all around, going to Connecticut, play a team like, you know, the University of Connecticut at Avery Point in Connecticut. Going all around New England, playing these very good basketball programs. And then coming out last weekend, winning their tournament in their own backyard, winning the state championship, getting that hardware, and now coming here to Springfield, going against a BCC team who you beat last week. It's hard to beat a team twice.
It is. Now we're going to go to the floor and listen to the presentations of the trophies to each team.
And there was some great basketball played here today. Congratulations to both teams. First, we're going to go with the all-tournament team, and we're going to recognize 2 players on the all-tournament team from Bristol Community College, which we all know is down in New Bedford, Fall River area. Sorry, man. Okay, so let's see. Number 4, Joshua Nelson. Also from Bristol, had a great tournament. Number 30, Jason Bing. Tournament team from Bunker Hill Community College. There are two selections. The first selection from Bunker Hill, wearing number 1, Elijah. Second all-tournament player from Bunker Hill, number 11, Freedom Daniel. Finally, this year's regional MVP, also from Bunker Hill. Number 12, David Stewart. Freedom's Dean. number 12, another, oh, wait a minute, MVP, David Stewart. Number 13, Mr. Sean Miller. Number 14, Evan Bean. Number 20, Zachary Abilhu. Badahu. Number 22, Anthony Gilardi. He's my favorite. That's an Italian name. He's my favorite. Number 24, Andrew Williams.
All right, well, there you have it. Bunker Hill hoisting that regional championship trophy for Region 21, which represents the fact that they're going to New York, putting a beating on BCC today, 97-78, the final here from Springfield Technical Community College. Andrew, what we've seen today is that Bunker Hill just, I mean, their presence just loomed too large. It was just too much to overcome.
Big team, strong team, better team won today. That's the way it all worked out. The bigger team won, the stronger team won, the faster team won. And that's how you're going to do it. Now they're going to go to New York, and they're going to be up playing some of the best teams across the country. So it's going to be interesting to see how Region 21 holds up with the rest of this country.
Well, hopefully they'll, hopefully they will represent the region well, represent Boston well. So I want to thank everybody out there for watching us on FR Media, watching us through this tournament and regional tournament this weekend here at Springfield Technical Community College. It's been a pleasure. Join us. Hopefully you're here next year when we'll be broadcasting all the Bristol Community College BayHawk home games live from Bishop Conley. So for myself, David Cardoza, alongside here with the infamous Double A himself, Mr. Andrew Augusta, you've been watching BayHawks basketball here from Springfield. The final score, Bunker Hill 97, the BayHawks 78.